Stay awake, for you do not know at which hour your Lord will return. Hey y'all, today is Thursday in the 21st week of Ordinary Time, and in the Gospel of St. Matthew, we hear Jesus say some very strong words. Stay awake, for you do not know at which hour your Lord will return. So many of the young people that I work with are obsessed with being kind, being nice, and avoiding confrontation, and sort of preaching this gospel of you do you. You do you, and so long as you're not, you know, violently, physically assaulting anybody, it's perfectly fine with me. And it can be, it is, tremendously scandalous when people, especially young people in Christian leadership, or people in Christian leadership in general, whether that's pastors or parish leaders, volunteers, when people who are in charge of formation and education are spreading the lies that contradict church teaching, just for the sake of being nice, for being accepting. Now, you'll notice, you can comb through all of the Gospels, and Christ Jesus never ever says, you decide what sin is, not me. He never says that. And then he never says accept people as they are sinful and sort of hope that everything turns out okay, because I'm going to come back and I'll give you plenty of warning when I do. So you have lots of time to, you know, get right with me and then get, you know, return to me in a way that is good and sanctifying. The Lord says none of those things. In fact, today he says, stay awake because you don't know. You don't know when I'm coming. And if that's the reality, if we don't know when the Lord is returning, we have to be prepared right now, right in this moment. So today's gospel asks us to deeply reflect, what are the church's teachings on artificial contraception? Not my opinion, not my neighbor's opinion, not what my doctor says. What's the Catholic Church's guidance? Or explicit statement on artificial contraception? What is it on abortion? What is it on in vitro fertilization? What is it on same-sex attraction? What is it on transgender ideologies? What are the Catholic Church's teachings? And if I don't agree with them, if I think that they're misguided or wrong or hurtful, how do I reconcile that? Can I still call myself a Catholic Christian if I believe something that's in direct contradiction to the Church's official teaching? Are you entitled to come up with your own ideas of what sin and sin isn't? Certainly not. And so when the Lord says stay awake, he doesn't mean stay woke. He certainly doesn't mean stay woke. What he means is be aware that I'm going to come back at any time, and whether or not you've spent your life being nice and agreeing with everybody and saying, it's okay, man, you do you, or whether you have gone against the mold, against the corruption of our society and our broken world, and preached the truth out of love and with tremendous charity to others who are in need of hearing it, that moment is coming, and you're not gonna know when. So don't hold off, don't put off, don't say I'll start going to Mass next week, I'll start going to Mass when it's convenient for me, I'll go to confession, you know, hopefully before I die. It is a tremendous tragedy when someone says I'll get right with the Lord before I die and they die before doing so. Don't let this be you. Stay awake because you do not know the hour at which your Lord will return. God bless you.